What is transactional outbox? How does it fit in Saga transactions? When we are building microservices, they participate in Saga transactions. There would be a lot of scenario where you are taking some orders online. There's an order service. It is writing an order into the order table. And then it need to publish a credit card information to another service for credit card processing. So it may use some event queue. So we have a problem. What if something goes wrong while updating in the database? It writes a message to the queue. So the system can become inconsistent. You have a failed database transaction and a event message which got processed. So one traditional way of solving this problem is using two-phase commit transaction. In microservices, that is not considered a good practice. If you come from .NET, Microsoft Word, you remember Complus, how complex that was. So here comes the transactional outbox pattern. The same services doesn't update the record and then publishes this event to a event broker. Instead, you create another table called outbox. You can call it and give any name. So you create this table and then you write another message relaying services, which reads any record entered into this box, outbox table, and pushes it to the message broker so that it gets processed. So that way you can reliably process this message. So you're committing this message to the database and it getting fed to a message broker reliably. So when you are reading this outbox, there are two patterns. One is transaction log trailing, which I liked it, I prefer. So it goes through the log and finding out any new message to be published to the message broker. And another traditional old way is polling, database polling. I don't like it, database polling, because you can take away resources, you can lock the table and create some overhead. If you're using this pattern, try to implement transaction log trailing pattern. So summarize, whenever a service need to write a message to the database and also it need to push this event to message queue, we can use transactional outbox pattern to solve this problem. Thanks for watching this video. If you like this video, like it, share it, and subscribe to this channel. Thanks for watching.